what is boundedness of a sequence. When do we call a sequence as a bounded sequence? Okay, if its range is bounded, then you can say that the sequence, given sequence, is bounded. So first let us see what is the range of a sequence. Let us just revise what is range of a sequence. Okay, sequence contains all the terms, whereas range contains only those terms without repetition. Okay, let us see one example. So let us take sequence Sn, whose formula is minus 1 whole power n. As Sn is a sequence, as I mentioned, you have to take n values from 1, 2, 3 and so on. Means n belongs to capital N, means n is a natural number, that is n is a positive integer. Okay, so if we put n is equal to 1, 2, 3, so on, we will get the terms of the sequence. Let us see what those terms are. So first term, it is denoted by S1, second term by S2, third term by S3 and so on. Okay, so now what is S1? Put n is equal to 1 here, so that you will get minus 1 whole power 1, that is minus 1. Next, S2. So, minus 1 whole power 2. So, which is nothing but plus 1. Next, S3. Minus 1 whole power 3, which is nothing but minus 1. And so on. Likewise, we can find out all the terms of sequence Sn. Okay. So, then we have to write sequence Sn as minus 1, plus 1. Third term, minus 1, again fourth term, plus 1 and so on. Likewise, we can write sequence Sn. Then, what is range? Range of sequence Sn. Range of sequence Sn. Here, we have to write only those images which are not repeated. Okay, we need not write all the repeated terms here. Simply, minus 1 is repeated so many times. You need not write minus 1 that many number of times. Simply you can write minus 1 for one time. So minus 1. And similarly plus 1 also. Okay. So only single one you can write. So this gives you range of sequence Sn. Whereas this is a sequence Sn and this is a range set of sequence Sn. Okay. Now coming to constant function. What is its range? Constant function means all the terms, all the natural numbers have been mapped to only single number, which is called constant. As I already mentioned, okay, 1, 2, 3, so on, you will have n as the domain for sequences. And now, here for a constant sequence, you will have only some number, some real number here we will have. Let me take it as some k. Okay, now all these natural numbers will be mapped to only k. Okay, then what is your sequence Sn in this case? Nothing but k, 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 k. Likewise here again. Okay, but when we come to range of sequence Sn for this particular constant function, range is simply single concept k. Okay, so range of constant function is single concept. Here range contains two elements. Okay, now let us see one more sequence. Sn is 1 by n, where n is greater than or equal to 1 and n belongs to z place. Okay. Now, let us see the terms of this sequence and also the range set of this sequence. So, now what is S1? S1 is 1 by 1, which is 1. S2 is 1 by 2. When n equal to 2, you will get S2, means second term of the sequence. Next, S3 is 1 by 3. Next, S4 is 1 by 4 and so on. Okay, so these are the terms of the sequence. So, how we will write sequence Sn? Sequence Sn is nothing but 1, 1 by 2, 1 by 3, 1 by 4 and so on. That is sequence Sn. Then what is range? Is there any repetition here? No, no repetition is there. So, sequence Sn and range of sequence Sn both coincided here. Okay, both the coincided. So here range is also equal to this same set. Okay, and now you observe these three examples. Here your range set is either finite or infinite. It is finite because it has only two elements. And here also your range set is finite because it contains only one element. Whereas coming to this sequence, range set is infinite because you will get 1 by 10, 1 by 1000, 1 by 10,000, so many elements you will get in range set. So, range may be be finite or infinite. Range may be a finite set or infinite set. Okay, so we have concluded that range set may be infinite or finite set depending on the sequence. Okay, next. Then, when can we say a sequence as a bounded sequence? Now comes the real question. When can we call a sequence as a bounded sequence? If its range is bounded, then we can say that the given sequence is also bounded. Okay, if its range is bounded, sequence becomes bounded. Then what about the boundedness of range? Boundedness of range means, suppose this is your real line. Okay, so this is 0. I am marking some points 1, 2, 3, 4, likewise. Okay, now just now I took an example of a sequence which is Sn is minus 1 whole power n, and I got a range as only two elements minus 1 and 1. So this element is there in my range set and this element is there in my range set. Okay, so when can I call this sequence as a bounded sequence? If this is bounded. Okay, so when can you say that this range is bounded? If it is both bounded below and bounded above. Okay, bounded below and bounded above. Bounded below means what? Again, bounded above means what? Okay, now let us see. Bounded below. A set is said to be bounded below if all the elements of the set must be greater than or equal to some number. Okay, means what? If there exists some number L on the real line so that this particular number is less than or equal to Sn for all n. Means for these two terms here in this particular example we have only two terms in the range set. Okay, so first let us see this example and then let us move on to the definition. So for these two numbers you must have some real number which is less than or equal to these two. Can't we have some real number here on this real line which is less than or equal to these two numbers, which is 1 and minus 1? Of course we can have so many real numbers here, isn't it? So minus 2 is there, if minus 3, if I go only for integers I get minus 2, minus 3, so on, or else minus 1.5, minus 2.7. So many real numbers are there which are less than this minus 1 and 1. So if I get at least one real number which is less than the terms of this range, then you can say that range is bounded below. Bounded below. Why? Because you are getting numbers less than this one. So then you can say that this set is bounded below. Okay. So coming to the definition, you must have there exists. This is the symbol for there exists. If there is at least one real number, here I am mentioning it as L, but because I am defining lower bound, so I have used only small l. Okay, so if there is some real number L such that L is less than or equal to Sn, it may be equal also. So you can take here minus 1 also. Okay, minus 1 is equal to minus 1 and minus 1 is less than 1. Okay, so that particular number, either it must be equal to Sn or it must be less than Sn when we consider each and every term of Sn. Is it clear? Now, coming to upper bound. Upper bound means to this side of the set. To the right side of the set, we must have at least one real number. Okay? Means, see, we have 1 in this set and minus 1 in this range set. So, we can have so many real numbers to the right side of this 1. Is it not? Which are greater than these numbers. So, in definition, how to write? There exists upper bound. I am defining the upper bound. Okay, so upper bound means I am using letter U. So, there exists some upper bound or there exists some real number U such that how this must be? This must be like all the terms must be less than or equal to that real number. Okay, so all the terms must be less or equal to U. For all n. Okay? So, whenever there is some real number less than or equal to the terms, then you can say that the set is bounded below. If there is a real number which is greater than or equal to these two, these two must be less than this, means this number must be greater than the set number, set terms. Okay, so there is some real number which is greater than or equal to Sn, then you can say that this particular Sn is bounded above. Okay, and in such a case you can say Sn is bounded below. Sn is bounded below. In the below case you can say that Sn is bounded above. So bounded below and bounded above. Now this particular L is called lower bound. L is called lower bound. In this case, any real number which is less than or equal to the terms of the range is called a lower bound. Okay, and here in this case U is called an upper bound. So any real number which is greater than or equal to the terms, okay, U is greater than or equal to Sn, is it not? So U is greater than or equal to Sn means this U is called upper bound, and this, and in this case we say that Sn is bounded above. Okay, now if a particular sequence is both bounded below and also bounded above, then you can say that Sn is bounded. Okay, if there is both lower bound and upper bound, okay, then the sequence is called bounded sequence. Okay, so we have learnt what is boundedness of a sequence. Sequence is said to be bounded if its range is bounded. When do we call range as bounded? If it is both bounded below and bounded above. So when do we call a range as bounded below? If there is some real number which is less than or equal to Sn for all n, then in that case you say that range is bounded below. And when do you call range as bounded above? If there is some real number which is greater than or equal to Sn for all n, then in that case you say that range is bounded above. Okay, if these two happen, then that range set is bounded, and so sequence is called a bounded sequence. Okay, now comes the question, how many lower bounds and how many upper bounds do a sequence have, and can it have more than one, or will it have at least one? Those many number of questions will arise after defining boundedness of the sequence. Okay, let us take the same example, minus 1 whole power n, in which range set contains only two terms, minus 1 and 1. Okay, now just now I said any real number which is less than or equal to Sn always becomes a lower bound. Okay, if it is less than the terms, it becomes a lower bound. Okay, minus 1. See, the terms are only minus 1 and 1 in the range set. Can I write minus 1 as less than or equal to these two terms? Yes, of course, minus 1 is equal to minus 1 and minus 1 less than 1. So, minus 1 is a lower bound. Let us move on to another one. Minus 1.5. Is it not less than or equal to minus 1, 1? Minus 1.5 is less than minus 1 and minus 1.5 is less than 1. In this case, no equality condition. Okay, either it must be less than or less than or equal to. Okay, so for some terms it will be less than, and for some terms you may get equality condition. Okay, so in this case you are getting simply less than, so you can write less than or equal to. Okay, this is the most strongest condition than less than or equal to. So you can replace this less than by less than or equal to. Okay, now again let us move on to minus 2.7. do we have minus 2.7 less than minus 1? Of course, when we are moving towards left on the negative number line, your numbers become smaller. Okay, so minus 2.7 less than minus 1 and minus 2.7 is less than 1 also. So you can replace this less than by less than or equal to. So here how many lower bounds do we have? 3 lower bounds. Not only 3, many number of lower bounds you can find. Minus 1, minus 1.1, minus 1.112, minus 1.9. So many real numbers are there from minus 1 to towards left. Okay, so all those will become lower bounds for this particular sequence. So how many lower bounds do we have now? Infinite number of lower bounds. Similarly, coming to upper bound. Okay, upper bound means any real number which is greater than the terms. Any number which is greater than or equal to the terms becomes an upper bound. Okay, so now let us take 1. Okay, 1. is it not greater than minus 1 and is equal to 1? Greater than or equal to minus 1 and 1 we got. So 1 is an upper bound. Next, one more. 2. It is greater than minus 1 and greater than 1. For both the terms it is greater than. Here also, as we did in lower bound condition, here also 2 is greater than or equal to minus 1 comma 1. Okay. So again, one more. 3.25. Will it be an upper bound or not? Yes, 3.25 is greater than minus 1 and 3.25 is greater than 1 also. So here also you can put greater than or equal to. Okay. So all these are upper bounds for the particular sequence. So here also we have how many upper bounds? So many number of upper bounds, because on the number line if we move towards right, you may find so many number of real numbers which act as upper bounds for this particular sequence. So a sequence may have infinite number of lower bounds and infinite number of upper bounds. Okay. Then comes the question, is there any condition that the given sequence possesses lower bound and upper bound? Will it have upper bound and lower bound compulsorily? Let us see one example. Okay. Now I am taking this sequence SN as 2 power n. Okay. 2 power n sequence means here n is equal to 1, 2, 3, so on. So I am writing n is greater than or equal to 1 and n belongs to n. Okay. Means we have to take only natural numbers set. Okay. So let us see the boundedness of this sequence. First, to see the boundedness of the sequence, first step is we have to find out its range. Then only we can speak of its boundedness. So what is range? For that we have to find out the terms of the sequence. No? So S1, 2 power 1. Next S2, 2 square means 4. Next S3 means 2 cube means 8. Next S4, 2 power 4 means 16. Next so on. S5, 32, 64, 128, so many you get. Okay. So all these are terms of the sequence. So we got terms of sequence. Now we have to write range of sequence SN. Range means we have to pick only those terms which are not repeated and write. Only once we have to write. But is there any repetition here? No repetition. So we get all the terms in the range. Means 2, 4, 8, 16, all these will come in range. Okay. Now we have to see the boundedness of this range set. Okay. Let us mark that. For our convenience, we have to draw this, but in examinations, you need not draw. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, likewise. And here minus 1, minus 2, minus 3, so on. This is your real line. Okay. Now let us indicate the terms 2, 4, 8, and so on we have. So now we have to see whether this is bounded or not. Bounded means we have to check two conditions. Bounded below property and bounded above property. Okay. So bounded below means we must have at least one real number which is less than these terms. Okay. Here it is never ending. So I put some continuous dots. Okay. Dots I kept. So that means you have to understand that there are so many terms. But to the left of this it is only 2. We don't have any term to the left side of 2 in the range set. Okay, 2 is the least value. Now, can we have some real number which is less than or equal to these many number of terms? Yes, of course. 2. Before 2 we have 1. Even 2 is also there. 1, 0, minus 1, 0.5. So many real numbers are there which are less than these terms. Is it not? So, can we say that now this range set is bounded below? If there is at least one number which is less than the terms, you can say that range set is bounded below. Here we are having so many number of real numbers which are less than these terms. So obviously this range set is bounded below. Now moving on to bounded above property. Okay. So in this set, we have to get some real number which is greater than these numbers. Okay. Suppose I wrote only up to 16 here. Okay, but here there is so on is there. Okay, after 16 we will get 32, next 64, 128. So whatever real number you say, like greater than that real number, you can have 2 for some number. Okay, suppose I say some 129. Okay, so here what are the terms? 2, 4, 8, 16, next 32, 64, 128, 256 is there. Okay, if I say that 129 is greater than these terms means, but greater than is 129, you are having one more term, 256 in this range set. So this can't be an upper bound. Similarly, if you say any number greater than that number, you can find some term of this range set. So this is not bounded above. So there is a sequence which is not bounded above. This is not bounded above. Okay, have you observed that this range set is infinite? Okay, but in the previous example, our range set is finite, only two elements are there. So a finite set is always bounded. Finite set is always bounded, whereas an infinite set need not be bounded. Okay, yes. Now let us move on to one more sequence and see this boundedness property. Let us take sequence Sn as 1 by n, where n belongs to n. Okay, so 1 by n. So first let us write down the terms range and then speak of its boundedness. So what is the sequence Sn terms? N equal to 1, we will have 1 by 1 which is 1. N equal to 2, we will get 1 by 2. Next, 1 by 3, 1 by 4, so on. These are the terms of the sequence. Okay, now let us write range. Range is nothing but 1. Here there is no repetition, so we have to collect all the terms and write in the range set as it is. So 1, 1 by 2 means 0.5. For our convenience, I am writing decimals. Okay, 1 by 3 means 0.3 recurring. 1 by 4 means 0.25. Next comes 1 by 5, which is nothing but 0.2, and so on. Okay, so now we have range set. We have to see its boundedness property. Boundedness means again lower bound, upper bound, same old history. Okay, so let us draw a real line, and here I am taking only 0 and 1 and I am omitting the next remaining part of the real line. Okay, for our convenience I am doing this. So here I have marked 0 and here I have marked 1, and this is 0.1, 0.2, 0.3, 4, 5. Let us mark in the middle. Okay, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, and this is 1. Okay. First, suppose I didn't mark at equal distances all these points. Okay. 0.2, 4, 5, 0.5, 0.6, 0.7, 0.8, 0.9, and this is 1. Now let us see 1. We have 1 over here. Next 0.5. Just see how you are getting these lines when I am moving to the right side of the terms, I mean in the range set, how you are getting these lines on the number line, so that it will be easy for you to say upper bound and lower bound. 0.5. Next 0.3 returning means I can mark over here. Next 0.2 fine. Next 0.2. Okay. So when I am moving like this in the range set, I am getting lines like this. I am just running towards left, towards 0. Okay, I am getting lines towards 0. Okay, so whatever bigger n you take, whatever large n you take, you will get value as some 0.000. Okay, but not any negative value. So all your lines, now if you move like this successively, you will get lines very closer. Okay, closer to one another. But they won't go beyond this 0. You won't get any negative integer. Whatever is the large n you take, you won't get any negative integer. Okay? So, not even 0 also. We won't get 0 also. For any large n, you won't get 1 by n value as 0. Okay? So, it will stop at here. You will have 0 here. It won't touch 0 also. So, all your terms are in between 1 and 0. Okay? Not beyond 1 and not beyond 0. So now can you say lower bound and upper bounds for this particular sequence? Of course, 0 is a lower bound, is it not? 0 is less than or equal to all the terms of this range set. So 0 becomes a lower bound. And so this set is bounded below. At least one real number must be there which is less than or equal to all the terms. Then you can say that that set is bounded below. So here we have 0. And so this sequence is bounded below. Coming to bounded above property. Here we have 1. But here also we have some more real line. Okay, so beyond 1 there are so many real numbers which are greater than or equal to these many number of terms. Okay, so and even 1 is also greater than or equal to all the terms. So 1 is also an upper bound. And if not, so many numbers are there, you can take any one and can say that this set is bounded above. Suppose let me take 1.2. That is greater than or equal to all the terms of this sequence. Is it not? 1.2 is greater than or equal to a set for all n. So this 1.2 becomes an upper bound for the sequence. And so your sequence is bounded above. Okay. So there is bounded below property and bounded above property for this particular sequence. And so you can say that this sequence means this one is bounded.